Uganda potentially could export goods worth $425.79 million. That's an equivalent of just over 1.5 trillion, marked as the highest number of growth in the East African region in the 2020-2021 statistics report before COVID-19. Being a landlocked country depending on the Mombasa inlet, the election fever picking up momentum with a history of violence, the private sector leadership in Uganda is silently advising their members to route their shipments through Tanzania's port, a distance of 1,585.6 kilometers, until spoils from the August 9th polls are peacefully apportioned. Kenya, bordering Uganda to the east, is a key transit route for both imports and exports. In 2017, Kenya, which has East Africa's largest economy, had to deal with a bloody and divisive election. Ugly scenes badly disrupted business in most of the region, with Uganda bearing the biggest impact. Apart from the current spike in fuel prices, among others, the previous elections in Kenya had influenced the same, and fuel supplies prices spiked to over 10,000 shillings per litre on the black market as several fuel stations helplessly waved away motorists. Apart from prices, Kampala City Traders Association Kasita leadership says their members who lost merchandise in the wake of the post-election violence are yet to be compensated. This remains the case despite a Kenyan court in 2018 ordering its government to pay 16 Ugandan and Rwandan companies $63 million, an equivalent of 226 billion shillings, as compensation for trucks and goods lost during the post-election madness. This could be the cause of alarm for the Regional East African Business Council, a private sector arm asking Kenya to conduct peaceful elections on August 9th to ensure the movement of goods on the Northern Corridor. The internal East African community market has about 146 million consumers, while the common market for Eastern and Southern Africa, COMESA, comprises of 20 member states with a population of over 460 million. Rwanda, Kenya, Uganda and Burundi are all members. According to John Bosco Kalisa, the EABC CEO, the region expects a smooth transition and fairness in the electoral process with no disruption to economic activities and a void of a repeat of what happened in 2017. Kenya has been hard-pressed to assure its neighbors of safety of their goods and security on the northern route that links Uganda, Rwanda, South Sudan and DRC to Mombasa port, with government last week assuring the region of maximum security during the election period. Kenya Association of Manufacturers acknowledges that whenever there is an election, business tends to slow down, but the country remains resilient and will carry out a peaceful election and transition. In Kenya, businesses and citizens are struggling under the weight of additional punitive taxes by the government, which were enacted through the new financial acts. But Kenya Association of Manufacturers says any nation's development is tied to elected leaders, so elections are a fundamental part of a country's prosperity. Story by Lucius Kasoma for the news.